Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Standard 5th, Chapter Number 6, Stone Age, Stone Tools. In this chapter, we are going to see two points, that is 6.1, Types and Forms of Tools According to the Type of Task. 6.2, Stone Age Tools. Now let's discuss it in detail. First point, 6.1, Types and Forms of Tools According to the Type of Task. If we saw a shiny object buried in the ground, what would we do to take it out? Perhaps we would scrape it out with our fingers. If that did not work, we might try to dig it out from a twig or stick. If that too did not work, we would have to look for a pointed stone. That should do the job. But if it still doesn't, then we would have to get an iron rod to dig that shiny object out. This shows that we need to choose the tools according to the demand of the task. It means that whenever in childhood we play and we see something buried in the ground, what we do? We use different methods to take that object out from the ground. Means first of all we will see if we will get a stick or if we will buy with our fingers it will come out or what. After that we will see that whether if we will use a pointed stone or then also it will not get out. So what we'll do? We will take a different iron rod or another pointed thing to take that shiny object out from the ground. Like this only, the Stonish people, they were working and they were continuing their job. The following four factors determine our choice of tools. First one, availability of resources. Whenever we are on ground, what we will do? We will see some objects which will be available from the ground. Maybe stone or any stick, it can be easily available on the ground. Second one, minimal use of time and energy. And also we will see that how we can take out that object in limited time and in a limited energy. Means which object will be useful to dig that object from the ground. Third one, maximum efficiency. Means what? How we are going to work or in which way we are going to do, how much time we need and how much it is important to us. According to that efficiency, we will use maximum efficiency or we will try more and more different methods we will use to dig that amount from the or dig that object from the ground. Fourth one, skill of handling tools which is acquired through practice. It means that whenever we are going to take out that object from the ground, what we will do? We will use different skills. We will try to dig that object from the ground from different angles, or we will start scraping with our fingers also or by the stick, or we will try to dig it from the rod or another pointed thing we will find out from the sources of or from the nature. So like this only, apes like the chimpanzee also use stones to break seeds and nuts. They use sticks to stir the ants out from ant hills to catch them. Humans too have always been using tools such as bones, stones, dried twigs and sticks as tools. As we will see that the apes or chimpanzees, they use different stones or seeds or stones or different material to dig the ant hills to eat the ant. Means they are using their skills. They are using the stone and sticks to dig that ant hill and to collect the ant from the ant hill. Like this only, different they break seeds and nuts. If they want to break a nut or seed, what they will do? They will use a stone. They will hammer on it and they will break the seed and nuts to eat. With continuous and and minute observation, experimentation, and their inborn imagination, humans learned that they could sharpen rods, bones, sticks, and stones into tools to carry out their task more efficiently. They also learned that they could give these objects any shape they desired. It means that by observation, they had come to know that we can sharpen the rods, bones, sticks, and stones to make it a different type of tools. So they can carry the different tasks from by using that all materials. In the previous lesson, we saw that stone tools were found with the remains of Homo habilis. We can say that he made them because they were found near his remains. But did he make only stone tools? The answer to this question is no, because he made tools from other materials as well. Yes, in previous lessons we had seen that just not by using the bones or sticks or by the different stones. It means that they were using different things as they are changing their situation. As according to the situation, according to the efficiency, they were converting their mind towards that idea to catch it and to solve the problem. However, of the tools made by humans thousands of years ago, only the stone tools can be found today. Tools made from bone are rarely found, but since twigs and sticks decompose easily, we do not find any tools made from them. As we know that stone, it will take a long duration to decompose, but the twigs and sticks, they can decompose easily and in a limited duration. So the Stone Age people's materials, which we can see in the present time, that can be a stone. Here you can see different pictures they had given, 1 to 6 pictures they had given, you can see, and one description is given in the box. Tools made from stones and bones. First one you can see, a chopper made from a pebble. If you will see the picture, first one, it is a pebble. It is a chopper. Second one, a scrapper. The second picture you can see, it is a scrapper. Means to scrapen the animal's dead skins, it can be used. A circular hammer stone. Third one you can see, a circular hammer stone they are using. They can use this hammer to break the nuts or seeds, or to make make a paste. They can also use that chopper. A chopper made from a flake of stone. The fourth one you can see, it is a chopper made from a flake of stone. Means by sharpening or giving a different shape, so that can be used as a chopper for cutting different materials, for cutting fruits or vegetables or any other materials. Fifth one, a borer made from a bone. Fifth one you can see, it is a tool which is made up of bone. An antler used as a pick. You can see the sixth one, it is an antler, means to sharpen or to point out something or to carve something, they can use that antler, or to pick something from the ground. You can see Stone Age tools. The period from which mainly stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. It means that the period from which mainly the people, they were using the stone tools, that is only known as Stone Age. The Stone Age is divided into three periods on the basis of the shape and the type of tools found. The first one you can see, Old Stone Age or Paleolithic Age. Paleo means old and lithos means stones. Means Old Stone Age means the old people who were using the stone. Second one, Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age. Meso means middle. Middle means Mesolithic Age means the age, the period where the middle people, they were using the Middle Stone Age. Third one, New Stone Age or Neolithic Age. New means new. As these are the different three stages of Stone Age people, as first one Old Stone Age, second Middle Stone Age, third one New Stone Age. What it is and the detailed description is given below. The first one you can see, Old Stone Age, Paleolithic Age. Homo habilis and Homo erectus, who belong to the Old Stone Age, both made their tools using the precaution technique. This technique involves beating or striking one large pebble against another to obtain stone flakes. It means that one pebble was used to prepare another pebble. So, by breaking, by using that method, different flakes were used. This technique is known as percussion technique. The first tools made in the Old Stone Age with this technique were crude. Only one side of tools had a sharp edge. Such tools are known as choppers. They could only be used for breaking nuts or bones. The tools made by Homo habilis were of this kind. It means that the first one, the Old Stone Age people, they were using the pointed strips, which was one side pointed and another side normal. So this type of tools were used by Homo habilis people. They had not yet learned to hunt because they were yet not learned in the to hunt an animal. So in Old Stone Age period, we can come to know that the Homo habilis people, they were unable to hunt the animals. Flakes of stone would be produced while shaping his tools. He used the flakes for scraping meat from height, for chopping meat and other foodstuffs, for sharpening wood sticks, etc. It means that at that period, the meat and foodstuffs for scraping or for chopping, it was used, that tool was used for foodstuffs and to for the meat to chop it or to scrap the meat which is hidden inside of the bones. Tools like the hand axe and cleaver made by Homo erectus are more proportionate and symmetrical than the chopper made by Homo habilis. A proportionate of symmetrical tools has to be mentally visualized first. Only then it is possible to make it. Homo erectus could mentally visualize his tools even before he actually shaped them. To obtain stone flakes, he used things like antler as hammers. He further sharpened the edges of those flakes by scraping off smaller pieces to make scrapers with very sharp edges. It means that Homo erectus was using different tools for different tasks according to the demand of the task. It means that the Homo erectus are more proportionate by the symmetrical than the choppers made by Homo habilis. Means the Homo erectus people were having a good quality or a better tools than the Homo habilis peoples. As according to that period, their mentally visualization had been increased and different materials, different thinking had started in the Stone Age people. So they had started preparing different tools and different from small tools to bigger tools, they had started preparing as according to the need of their task. You can see here different diagrams that they had given. First one, you can see removing minute flakes from bigger flakes. You can see that the different materials are used to sharpen the given flake. A chopper they had shown, a stone hammer they had shown, another one removing minor flakes from the smaller flake. A hand axe is also given. We will move forward now. With his improved tools, Homo erectus could have a greater variety of food because of he could now hunt a variety of big and small animals. This included mainly the deer, bison, rabbit, etc. As improved tools for the Homo erectus people, they were able to hunt the animals easily as their tools had been made available and easier their work to convert the animals to be their diet. The Neanderthal man made further progress in tool making techniques. He began to make smaller tools. You can see about the Neanderthal man we had studied in the previous lesson. According to their progress, the tool making technique had given a progress for the Stone Age peoples. He began to make smaller tools from the different by using different techniques. Homo sapiens brought about a revolution in the technique of making tools. He devised a technique of obtaining long and narrow blades of stone. He made various implements like the knife, scraper, borer, chisel, etc. from these long blades. By using that long blades and by using the knife, they had converted the tools into different shapes and they had given it a different names. And according to the different tasks, yet they were using that tools according to their need. He also began to use ivory and rare stones of the quartz variety for making tools and other articles. Also, for making different articles or for making different tools, they were using that or previous stone tools. Homo sapiens had made significant progress in gaining knowledge of his environment and in the techniques of making tools and obtaining food. This enabled him to stay in one place for a longer period of time. Groups of Homo sapiens had begun to build hunts and live them in them. They had also started celebrating social festivals. Many artistic objects and cave paintings created by Homo sapiens were possibly meant for these festivals. Homo sapiens had started using ornaments to adorn themselves. Beads from the time of Homo sapiens made of shells, bones, and animal teeth have been found. Thus, the beginnings of human culture go back to the old Stone Age. It means that the Homo sapiens, they are significant of the progress of gaining knowledge from the environment. By studying the environment, they were coming to know the different techniques, and by using different, by making different tools, they were obtaining different foods from the environment. And this made them to stay at one place for a longer time and to hunt by staying at places and live their life. Like this only, they had started celebrating social festivals for their enjoyment. Many different artistic objects they had started preparing by making use of different tools and by making different techniques used in their articles. Also, possibly meant by the Homo sapiens, the festivals, they had made their enjoyment larger. So, they can enjoy their life, they can eat, they can collect the food by staying at places. This made the people to stay at one place and create a social life. Different beads from the time of Homo sapiens made of shells, bones and animal teeth have been found. It had been buried and we had got the samples of beads and of the Homo sapiens which they had using as a jewelry, as an ornament. Different shells they were using, different bones and animal teeth they were using as a ornament. Remains of tools from the old Stone Age have been found in India at various places. From Kashmir to Tamil Nadu, the old Stone Age have been found in India. Fossils of a human skull and the collar bone of an old Stone Age woman were found on the banks of the Narmada in the vicinity of Hathnora, a village near Hoshangabad in Madhya Pradesh. Besides that, the fossilized skull of a child from the Stone Age was found at a village near Pondicherry. Some remains in old Stone Age humans have also been found in Afghanistan and Sri Lanka, Gangapur near Nashik and Chirki Nivasa near Nivasa are among the well-known old Stone Age sites in Maharashtra. Gangapur is on the banks of the Godavari River and Chirki Nivasa is in the Pravara Basin. It means that at different places, different tools and different Stone Age people's things we had found, fossils we had found, from which we can come to know that in Maharashtra also and in India also, different Stone Age people had survived and their remains are found in India and also in Maharashtra. The second stage of Stone Age is Middle Stone Age, that is Mesolithic Age. Homo sapiens in the Middle Stone Age continued to make progress in many different ways. They domesticated the dog. Due to changes in the climate and the environment in the Middle Stone Age, the way of life of humans had begun to change. Besides hunting, Homo sapiens had started to harvest food grains that grew in the wild and to domesticate animals. Their diet now included various plants, foods. They also began to settle in one place for a part of the year. Domestication of sheep and goat also goes back to this period. Taking all this into account, it appears that Homo sapiens now needed several different types of tools that were light in weight and durable for a variety of tasks such as hunting, fishing, harvesting, cutting of trees, etc. He used to make implements like the knife and the sickle by firmly fixing a row of blades as small as fingernails into groove in a bone or a piece of wood. Here, in more Middle Stone Age, we can see that the Homo sapiens, they were the people who were in Middle Stone Age. They had continued the progress which previously the Old Stone Age people had been found. And according to their study, they had invited different materials. By observing from the climate and from the environment, they had come to know that how the life of humans had begun to be changed and how to survive in this environment they had come to know. Besides hunting, Homo sapiens had started harvesting food grains. They had now come to know that how to grieve in the wild and in the domestic animals, how to do the domestication of animals. They had come to know the diet now included various plants, foods. Also, they had started settling at one place for a part of a year, means for a year, complete whole year, they were settling at a place where beside a river or at a forest. They can easily collect water from that places and also they can hunt the animals from the forest. Domestication of sheep and goats also goes back to this period. It means that domestication now a time also we are doing domestication of goats and sheep. So we can come to know that. From Middle Stone Age, the domestication of animals are done, and now a time also some people they are doing the domestication of animals like sheep and goat. Homo sapiens, they needed some different types of tools that were light in weight and durable for a variety of tasks. Means they had converted the tools to make it lighter, to carry it easily from one place to another places, or for hunting, or for going while going for the forest, they need a small and a good quality of tool. So they had converted that tool into different shapes and in a small and a durable variety of tasks to use it. Such hunting, fishing, harvesting, cutting of trees, this small tools had been used for this type of work. or while fixing a row of blades as small as fingernails, like this type of bone or piece of wood can be used for different tasks in that period of Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age. Many sites of the Middle Stone Age have been found in India. Among them, Begor in Rajasthan, Bhimtek in Madhya Pradesh, Langnej in Gujarat and Patne in Jalgaon district in Maharashtra are the well-known ones. As we can come to know that the Middle Stone Age, it had been famous in this all places, which is given in this textbook. You can see one content about the Middle Stone Age they had given. Let's see. In Middle Stone Age, the stone blades used to make implements were removed from the stone by the fluted core technique. Flute means a long parallel side depression on the stone, and core means the original stone from which the blades are moved. After the blades were removed from the stone from all sides, the remaining core had such flute on all sides. Blades removed with this technique are very minute. The size of a nail or slightly bigger, hence they are called as microliths. Micro means very small and lithos means stone. In the Middle Stone Age, arrows were made by fixing a microlith at the tip of a stick. You can collect this information, which is given on page number 28 of your textbook. You can easily read that content and you can come to know by different diagrams they had given. A fluted core, you can see the first one. Microliths, Middle Stone Age, different sharpened Stone Age people's, means the stones which were they were using, which was lightweighted. A knife with an edge like a saw made by fixing microliths, Middle Stone Age. This is one of the different type of saw which was made by the Middle Stone Age people. Fish hooks of bones, you can see. Another one they had given, arrows with microliths as tips, Middle Stone Age. To scrapen the meat or hunt an animal, they were using these arrows. Let's see the remaining part. New Stone Age, that is Neolithic Age. In this period, stone tools that were polished to give a smooth, shiny finish were made for the first time, as this was a new type of tool making technique. This period was named the Stone Age, New Stone Age. You can see that why they had given it the name as New Stone Age. In this period, the stone tools that were polished to give a smooth and shiny finish. So they had given, tool making technique had been improved. So they had given the name it as New Stone Age. By the time of the New Stone Age, agriculture and domestication of animals or animal husbandry had become a routine way of life. Hunting was no more the major means of obtaining food. It became secondary to agriculture and animal husbandry. There are many sites of New Stone Age culture in India, especially along the Ganga River and in the South India. Here you can see that the time of the New Stone Age, agriculture and domestication of animals or animal husbandry had become a routine way of their life. So hunting was no more the major means of obtaining food, because they had learned to collect different materials from the forest, and their diet had been changed. So it became a secondary to agriculture and animal husbandry. So a New Stone Age, it can be seen in different places of India, that is South India, and mostly it is in especially along with the Ganga River. We can find out of the New Stone Age, Neolithic Age. So now we will see what points we had discussed in this lesson. If you will see, the selection of tools is determined by availability of resources, minimal use of time and energy, maximum efficiency and skill of handling tools acquired through practice. These were the points which we had seen in this lesson. As also we had seen that the stones, bones, sticks and dried twigs were used as a tool in the Stone Age. Also we had seen stone tools are found today, but the bone tools are rare. Tools made of sticks and twigs have disappeared due to decomposition. And also we had seen that the period from which stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. It is divided into three stages. The first stage was Paleolithic Age or Old Stone Age. Second one we had seen Mesolithic Age or Middle Stone Age. The third Stone Age which we had seen is Neolithic Age or Neo Stone Age. In short, we will see what is different sites of Stone Age sites in India are. First one, Old Stone Age sites are Hathnor village in Madhya Pradesh, a village near Puducherry Gangapur near Nashik, and Chirki Nivasa near Nivasa. Middle Stone Age sites are Bagor in Rajasthan, Bimtek in Madhya Pradesh, Linganaj in Gujarat, and Patne in Gujarat in Maharashtra. The third one, New Stone Age sites are here area along Ganga River and South India. There are Old Stone Age sites in Afghanistan and Sri Lanka also. Do you know, microliths, that is very minute blades, were carved out of big stone by fluted core technique. Microliths were fixed on the top of stick bone to make an arrow. Sickle and knife were also made by fixing microliths into groove in a bone or piece of wood. That's all for this lesson. In next 7th lesson, we are going to see about from shelter to village settlements. First of all, complete the given exercise and read the taught chapter in detail. Observe the pictures and try to draw the picture which is given on page number 25 and 26.